session starts now at 10:30. The way it works, you have like five EC stations and five MAC stations. You stay for 25 minutes, and then I'll make an announcement, and you choose another session and rotate. So enjoy the session.
Video settings. Maybe if I can put it into Melee.
Are you a teacher or a technician or a
teacher? Yeah. Oh, Bobby's online. Okay. Hello. Can you hear us? Okay.
Where did you get this from?
She's one of the participants in Learning Together, so she's joining our meeting. I don't know what I can do about my video. I think I'm just not going to worry about it. So let's see, that's that one. Don't really have time to worry about it. So I have to unmute her. Or maybe I can do it from, oh, here we go. There we go. Hi. Hello. Okay, we have to see if we can get you. Okay, can you try the microphone again?
Hello?
Yes. Okay, excellent.
That's better.
Yes. Okay, great. So we're talking today about learningtogether.net. Let me put up a screen here. Let's see, I'll just share my screen.
Okay.
That'll be a lot nicer looking than my... Okay, so I'm just sharing my screen here. Okay, there's my video there. Can you introduce yourself? You've been a Learning Together participant for some time.
Yes, I'm Bobby Stevens, and I have been a part of the Learning Together for many years. I am a KG1 teacher, but interested in ESL as well.
Uh-huh. Okay. We're sitting here with somebody. What's your name?
Saba.
Saba is here.
Hi, Saba. Saba is here.
And also, do you want to come here? Okay. We have someone else here. His name is Andrew.
Okay. Hello, Andrew.
Andrew is here and Saba. And you're coming in loud and clear.
Great.
And good to know. Basically, well, what we're doing Learning Together episode, these are all the Learning Together episodes. We're doing the next one, episode 404. We're doing it live here at TESOL. And let me just get rid of that. Didn't want that to happen by accident. Okay, so let me, Learning Together is from the handout. You have a handout?
Yeah.
Okay, so this link takes you to Learning Together. I'll put it here on the screen. This is the... Well, let's go to learningtogether.net. Okay, if I go there, open the new open link. Okay, this is... Oh, I hate that. It's driving me crazy. There we go. Move that down. Okay, so this is what they're seeing in Zoom. So here. Okay, let me just go here. Okay, so that link takes you to learningtogether.ppworks.com, and Learning Together is just a portal page for the wiki. My idea at one point was that people could join the wiki, and they can, and then they could write in their proposals for things they want to do. This is a webcast series. It's been going on since 2010. So this is our events that we have coming up. Okay, so there's right now we're at this one. This is the webcast that you're in right now, episode 404. I have an archive. We have here an archive of all our past events. This opens in a new page. So there we go. So this is everything we have done to date. We've done 400 episodes since 2009 or 10. So all of these are the episodes here. They all link to, let's say this one right here would link out to the archive that you're looking at over there.
Who's your intended audience?
You, Jane, and Bobby. She's here in here remotely. And where are you from, Bobby? Where do you live now?
I live in Penang, Malaysia.
Malaysia, okay. Yes. All right. So anyway, she's joined because she knows where the meeting is. This is the here at let's see, upcoming presentations. She's gone here and that's the wrong one, sorry. That one right there. Okay. She's come here and she's found the Zoom meeting. Mm-hmm. There's a Zoom meeting. And I invited a lot of other people to come with us. I just tweeted just now that we're going to be here. You never know, we might attract people, and also I announced the events in other places as well. So I've announced this one in all these spaces.
What's the thing that we're going to learn together?
Yeah. Aren't you right now about learning together? I mean, normally we'll have a presentation like the one that you see right here, looking at this last one that we did. If I go back to the just learningtogether.net. Oh, my mouse is appearing over here. So this link here, learningtogether.net.
It's like distant learning.
It's a community of practice. It's really a community of learners. Okay, so learningtogether.net.
How can this be used in the classes or for students benefit? How can it serve students?
Well, what Learning Together does is it teaches teachers how to use it in classes. The teachers interact with one another, and they learn how they can do it. So if you don't know anything about it, you can't just pop into class and do it. The students need to learn how to do it. So you need to learn that there's a community that you can interact with and how to interact with them. And maybe, I don't know how I can get back to where I was. Let's see if I can get back here, maybe. Where did I start there? This one is just not learningtogether.net. It's just not, it should work, but I guess it's a network problem. But anyway, we can see it over here. So this is the last one that I did. Okay, so in this one, I'm meeting a bunch of other teachers. And what I talked to them about was, let me just put this onto something this will go into this is on our webcast, okay, so people can see something on the screen. Okay, so this one, I showed some people at a university in Oman how they can use Google Docs to give feedback on student writing, but not only that, the technique that I've developed using the voice in Google Docs to give comments to the students while they're writing on their devices, and I go to their document and I see what the student is writing. I make a comment and then I speak the comment into the computer, and the comment appears in the student's document on his computer or her computer. And that's one way. So I met them with the teachers and explained to them how to do it. And another thing I hit at the same time, this one is about getting the students to write on paper. You read into Google Docs that they've written in good English. You give that back to the students with a printout. So you give them their writing, original writing with errors. And you give them a printout of the same thing in good English. And you write on the printout suggestions for them to improve their writing. So I had several papers that I, if you go there and find the link, then you can link to the presentation itself. The presentation is recorded, so you can see me presenting that. And you can find all the artifacts here that take you to the articles I wrote about it and things like that. So it's a comprehensive, that's kind of a teacher training thing. But the thing about learning together is that the teachers themselves can come back and teach us. So this is not just these teachers. Let me see if I can get back to my index here. I'm going to, because I'm working on two computers. This one is for the pet, the podcast. Okay, so in my index, which I have here, this is an index of all the podcasts we've done, all the 400 we've done. So other teachers have come on and talked about similar things. Jane here is a participant in Minecraft. And when we, Minecraft was an electronic village. This is an electronic village here. We have an electronic village online that we do for 5 weeks a year in January and February every year. So that's kind of integrated with learning together. Electronic Village Online is a bunch of teachers put on training sessions for other teachers. So
I think this is written in the timetable in the program.
Yes,
I read about this in the program.
Yes, it's in the program. Yeah. So, and then you can catch up on everything I'm telling you here. And you can see we're recording this right now. So
you're using Zoom.
Yes. Over the last 10 years, this has been going on for 10 years, and this archive index you can see that we started a long time ago, mini scrolls.
It's really a big project. 10 years working on these things. So how many people have, do you contact in the world?
Oh, well, this is the community of practice aspect. This is the first one, 2009. So, yeah, we have a community of practice, something I call Webheads in Action, that's been going on since 2002. So these network teachers, get together and teach one another. And that's what learning together is about. This is only one of our communities. So the Electronic Village, Electronic Village Online is another community. And Jane here. There's Jane. Hi, Jane. So this is all being podcast. So,
and by Zoom, you can enter the other part, the computer, right?
Zoom is free. You can do it free for 30 minutes.
You can enter their computer, right? You can take a copy of their computer.
You can take a recording. It's making a recording now. It makes a recording on your computer. So one way, for example, suppose you learn how to do this because you interact with other teachers, and you're starting now to see how it might work. If you joined a community of practice, or just come into learning together and see how we do it, you'll learn how we can set up these things. And then you might think, well, you know, why don't I bring an expert to my class? I don't know what you're teaching. What are you teaching?
What do I teach?
Yes.
ESL.
ESL, where?
You know where.
In Arab countries somewhere? It's the wrong side. I can't see that.
With your son.
Oh, in Qatar. Oh, they told me to keep an eye out for you. Yes. I've been introduced already. Okay. Oh, okay. Excellent. My son, that's the...
Yesterday, I asked him, actually, what is your father...
That's right. Yeah. Excellent. Well, he told me...
And now
me
I know you just here. Because you look like him.
Okay, there you are.
And you look like him, not just in appearance. You look like him in technology.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, and he's so proficient.
Yes,
so confident.
Yeah, both of us can talk a lot about it. Yes. But we also walk the talk.
Yeah, his son is always helping us at work. Really?
Yeah, he works with us. He does web Camtasia.
He does quickies, yes.
Camtasia instructions on how to use Blackboard.
Yes. Yeah, he's really
he amazes amazing. Me. He amazes amazing me with person. His knowledge of Camtasia.
Did he tell you that I was looking for you?
He did. I got a WhatsApp message on my phone last night saying where would I be, and I should be looking for a lady from Kuwait.
Kuwait? No.
From Qatar.
Qatar.
Okay. Okay. Anyway, okay. So I was expecting you, and here you are.
I intentionally come to see you and to see and okay. really to congratulate you on having such a son.
Okay. Well, if you in your class, if you're using some materials that say talk about let's say ocean ecology, you could contact say somebody in the Ministry of Fisheries and Akar to come to you, to come in Zoom and to speak to your class about this topic.
Yeah, I know Zoom. I know. I use Zoom.
Okay, so you and you could.
I know. I use Zoom for just 2 days ago. I had a Zoom contact with somebody in Qatar.
Okay. Well, yeah. You, but a lot of people know how to do it, but you don't really know how to integrate it into your teaching. So you already know.
Yes.
So this is what our community of practice does, is it brings teachers together to learn how they can learn from one another. And that's actually why Jane and I are in Minecraft. We're learning about gamification in our teaching. So we do that by teaching each other, by joining each other in the game. And you know, you would think this is a waste of time, but no, it turns out that, I don't know, you could, what do we learn in Minecraft?
Well, learn a lot.
Yeah, well.
In our community, we're not just learning Minecraft, of how to incorporate language lessons in Minecraft, but because of bands, when we do that great gameplay, we wanted to record it, and we wanted to be able to analyze the students or a participant's interaction, and Vance taught us how to do stream gameplay and put it online so that we can analyze it later on, because our participants come from all over the world. We have people from Romania, we have people from Brazil, we have people from the U.S., Pennsylvania, Taiwan. It's a game.
Like the original Minecraft?
Yes. Well, actually, they keep improving it. They've got an undersea world there now. So that's what we do this for 5 weeks in the year. And so we integrate this. Let me show the... I wonder if this one will work, because we've got an online audience as well. It's not really an audience, but we're doing this.
Now, what we're talking now about, you can record it here and then make it as a listen, for example.
Yes.
Recording.
Yeah, and maybe I can get this on through here.
So now you're part of learning together. Episode is going to be online.
Yes.
So if there's anything you'd like to share and add.
Yeah, let's see.
For me, my nature, I don't like to communicate with too many people in the world. This is my nature.
Uh-huh.
You know, I prefer face to face. I don't like that's why I don't have Facebook. I don't have any kind of. I prefer face to face.
Yeah. Okay. So,
you know what?
In my case, I'm responsible for teacher training.
Uh-huh.
For our ESL program, for our 11 teachers across the U.S., so that's kind of
this is good for you.
Me into.
This is so yes.
Year. Do you go to ISTE conferences?
Do I go to what?
ISTE, no. ISTE. Okay, Minecraft is very big at ISTE. Okay. You know about ISTE?
No.
Oh, okay. That's a big technology conference, educators technology conference. Microsoft bought Minecraft, so. And they're marketing it, especially at ISTE. They've got an exhibition floor that's probably five times the size, and a big central part of it is Minecraft. So they're very big in education. So if you wanted to learn more about that, one way would be to join a community of practice like ours, or there are so many, and learn more about it that way. But I meet a lot of high school teachers who are using Minecraft, but it's not just Minecraft. I don't know, how about the K-12 online conference? Wesley Fryer, Steve Denbo. Okay, anyway, where are you working exactly?
With UTP High School.
UTP is what? Utah?
No, we're University Track Preparation.
We
partner with private schools across the U.S. to provide an international program at those schools for those schools and deliver an excellent experience for our students.
Let me do a sound check. Bobby, can you understand what Andrew is saying?
Absolutely. Yes, coming in clearly.
To our program with the idea of going on to the top 100 universities here in the U.S.
Okay.
international students.
Yeah, well, learning together, you know, if anybody could come and do a learning together session, you could come into learning together. You could come with Dusty. You could bring Dusty into learning together. You could join him and we could talk to him about what you do in Qatar, or we could talk to you about what you do. You didn't tell me the city though. Where are you? Are you in Atlanta?
We have 7 schools across the country, 2 in New York, 2 in New Hampshire, 2
okay.
in Florida.
Okay, so you, Arizona. You don't live anywhere. You live in a suitcase.
I live in New York.
Dusty is part of your learning together group.
Well, yeah. That's his mother. That's Dusty's mother.
What is that?
Look, we're talking. You can hear us talking about Dusty, right?
We have 5 more minutes, and then we rotate.
Oh yeah.
This is Saba. She works with Dusty.
Yes. Hi, Dusty.
Yeah.
Hey, Saba.
Just yesterday, I sent emails to Mr. Dusty asking him about his father, and he told me he's working here today about learning together. That's why I came to attend his session.
But we learn a lot from each other.
So your son, by the way, is
yeah.
And everything.
And we basically interact with teachers, and we, teachers who wish to be in communities of practice and wish to learn that way.
Maybe I'll see you in Qatar. I'm coming there.
She said she'll see you in Qatar. She said she'll see you in Qatar. She's coming there.
You're not living in Qatar?
We're not living in Qatar, but we're going to visit our sons and grandchildren in Qatar. Probably next month.
Really?
We'll look for you.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay. So now it's time to rotate. So hang on a minute while I rotate.
All right.
Okay, bye. Thank you. Why?
Okay. I rotated. All right. Why? Because he said it was time to rotate.
But by the way, your son is not like you. He doesn't have this sense of humor.
He doesn't?
He doesn't.
You haven't?
Has it quietly. Vance, you're frozen.